Going on, brother? Good.
I look cute, innit?
You look cute. Thank you. Levi's shirt, doing Thank bits.
You. How do you know it's Levi's?
It says Levi's all over it.
Let's go with Seville squares.
Doing your thing.
Good weekend?
Yeah, good. I got a fact for you.
I got it.
Did you know that over 2/3 of the world have never seen snow in real life?
That's just like, wow. That's more than half.
Two-thirds of the world have never, they don't even know that snow is a real thing.
I know, but
you've just seen it on television, in movies.
Yeah, but they know it's real.
Well, if you haven't seen it, how do you know it's real?
Because it's on TV.
A lot of things on TV that aren't real.
True.
What's going on, people? Welcome to Take a Bow. This is the show.
Good fact.
Thank you. Where we get the funniest stuff on the World Wide Web and we deliver it straight to you. It's Craig Mitch, Stevo The Madman. And if you have never seen snow and you're watching this in a part of the world where snow doesn't exist, let us know.
Yeah, for real.
Because they could be watching this in like, where's Specs from?
Zimbabwe. No, Sudan.
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 They may have never seen snow in Sudan.
I don't think they have.
That's bang on the equator.
Or Mallorca.
Quickly, quick one on England's performance against Spain.
We done well, but you was there. Did they look good? Did they do what Southgate was saying?
Yeah, well, this is quickly all I wanted to say. Like, before the game, I see him giving an interview and he basically said that we want to be aggressive with the ball, press when we don't have the ball, and be clinical when we get our chances. And I think in the first half, that is exactly what they did. So clearly, whatever he said was drilled into them because they did that.
I think from about probably the 60th, that's when Spain like stepped it up.
Oh, and,
but England again done well.
Really knew when to go down.
Yep.
And you know,
Harry went down for about an hour.
Oh yeah, I would have did that.
With Ramos.
But yeah, I was there, bro. The atmosphere was so hostile. Yeah, it felt like something of huge importance. Yeah. Okay. Let's get in with some comments though. Forget all the international stuff. This is Premier League weekend. Daniel Campbell said, "Ha ha ha! Steve-O's Mitch impression." It was quite funny. And then Kudazi also said that Mitch impression was on point. Everyone's loving it. Coach Gerald Lamy said UEFA B is level 3.
Yeah, exactly. No, them ways
like
there.
Coaching badges and stuff. Well, you got that.
I was
UEFA
on my
B,
way, bro. Oh no, I needed to get my hours in, but I didn't end up going back. And if you don't act on your badges within, like I think 2 years it is, then it gets wiped. So it was all for nothing.
Nah, well, I mean, at least you learned stuff during it. Zozi Osuma said, "Damn, Steve-O coming with them vocals." Authentic Sithole said, "Am I just a small town girl? Dead." Fill in the songs. Yeah. Can't find my glasses. Steve-O sounded like he was a part of the High School Musical cast from way back and decided to bring out all the vocals again.
Zac Efron.
Mad team.
Did you know about him?
Yeah, of course. Oh. Vanessa Hudgens. Simon Homer said, "Is the oldest player Sol Bamba?"
Yes, it is. Yes, yeah, of course it is.
And his team.
I knew the answer.
Answered the question.
Well done.
You done
Thank you for getting involved with the comments and with that competition. We've got another one at the end for you. I enjoy that. Getting on with the show.
Yes.
First post comes from Craig Mitch. And it's a picture of Mourinho holding up the 3, saying, "Chelsea fans, put some respect on his name. This man is an icon round your bits." And I agree with you, bro. I see you. And by the way, yeah, exactly.
Go on.
I know you take great enjoyment out of winding up the Chelsea fans, but you had a point, bro. Like, I can't believe, and this is why loyalty.
Are you implying that I was trolling with this?
I believe you believe what you were saying and you meant it, but I believe you took great joy in trolling, yes. 100%.
No. 100%.
That's why you walked away. There's one snap you done. You got all the way away from the ground. It said, "Now I'm going to say what I feel."
Because there was like hundreds of thousands of Chelsea fans around me. No, okay, there's a little bit of trolling, but really it was just about being at the game and just hearing them saying F off Mourinho. And for me, I was just like, whoa.
Yeah.
Like, this man, who was Chelsea before Mourinho, really? What was your thoughts on the game?
Another good game.
Yeah.
So the last game that we said was the best game in for the last 5 years, was that Chelsea as well?
The Chelsea-Liverpool game?
Chelsea-Liverpool, mate. I'm starting to think that this Chelsea team
is
providing some moments in the Premier League.
But the thing is, I don't even think they were great yesterday. So the first goal with Rudiger, yeah, decent goal. Mm-hmm. You know, I think Pogba probably should have done a bit better from
should've
that corner.
Should have done a lot better.
Then after that, it was pretty much Man United, especially second half.
Yeah.
And then the second goal from Ross Barkley, scrappy, but obviously equalises. I don't think they were playing that particularly well, Chelsea.
No, but, okay. Providing moments, you could have a bad game, but just the style of your game. It's like when Arsenal, anytime Arsenal played, like when they was on their job, because they played so freely going forward, if they had a bad game, there was still space and other teams, you know what I mean? It'd always be a good game. And I think Chelsea, they're more concentrating on wanting to score. I know they do the counter-attack, but they want to score, they want to entertain, and that leaves gaps, man.
Yeah.
So that's the least I think I've seen Jorginho touch the ball this season.
All right, so obviously we spoke about the game, but we got to speak about the beef. Now, what's your thoughts on what happened? Because everyone's chiming in, having their say, oh, Mourinho shouldn't have reacted the way he did, the assistant manager shouldn't have done what he did. What's your take on it?
Was that the assistant or was it a coach, right?
It was one of the coaches, right, yeah.
I think Mourinho, again, I've spoken about this before, about picking your moments. Now, Mourinho easily could have gone after the game, knocked on the dressing room, had it in the tunnel, had it in there, done whatever. But doing that in front of the TV cameras, you're showing us that your head's not in the right place and you're easy to get to, you know what I mean? Would I have done it, what Mourinho done? Probably.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I would have probably still switched, but yeah. I'm not Mourinho. I'm not like the most, at the moment, like you said, the most attacked guy in football, you know what I mean? So start using your head. That's what I'm thinking about that. Yeah. But the guy obviously annoyed him.
Was Mourinho entitled to react like that?
Listen, yeah. We can't say how people's emotions, we can't talk about people's emotions. Emotions, they do what they want, you know what I mean? But I'm just saying, you gotta have fire, what's the saying? Fire in your belly, ice in your head. You need a cool head, bruv. So you can get wound up.
Stevo Gems again, there's gonna be a meme with that one. You need fire in your belly and ice in your head.
Yes.
Here's my take on it.
Go on.
I feel like if the exact same thing happened at any other stadium, he doesn't lose his head like that, I reckon. So same thing, equalizer, 96th minute, he's under pressure, needs the points. Manager starts pumping and doing that stuff. Twice. I don't think he loses his head. I think because he's at Stamford Bridge, in his head he's thinking, do you know who I am here?
Yes.
On top of that, just before that, the fans are saying F off Mourinho and winding him up.
So that's emotion. So man, he's...
I think just because it was at Stamford Bridge,
he's entitled to do it, but is it right? No.
No, of course, like everyone needs to keep there. Is that what we said about Khabib?
Would he get fined for that?
Potentially. But I mean, they've all sorted out. They have to look at the referee's notes. But what I find interesting is that this Marco Ianni guy has been at Chelsea for 5 minutes, from what I know. Is he part of Sarri's coaching staff? So he's been there for 5 minutes, I'm assuming, right? Marco, he's Italian, it looks like. So you've been there for 5 minutes. Mourinho's put in some serious years at Stamford Bridge. I just think that's disrespectful.
Mm-hmm. But you're saying it's disrespectful, which it is. Maybe that's what the guy wanted. Maybe that's what Marco wanted.
So then why did he run down the tunnel?
Okay.
Don't bite off more than you can chew,
well,
bro.
He's the factual evidence of an internet troll.
Literally.
Yeah.
He is literally a Twitter egg.
Yes. Would you agree? Because I think this.
Yeah.
That Man United players are playing for Mourinho now.
Yeah. Oh,
haven't stopped playing for Mourinho.
Yeah.
Newcastle, Chelsea now.
No, they are. What I found interesting though was I think it was Mata after the game in a post-match interview. He said, yeah, like you could see, you know, we wanted to win, we're playing for the badge, we're playing for ourselves and we're playing for the fans. And I didn't get the manager in there. I didn't see a manager in there. He named three different entities. So we're playing for the badge, we're playing for ourselves and we're playing for the fans. He literally said those three
things. Maybe he includes the manager in that. Can we not big up Mourinho for actually getting into Martial? Martial taking that criticism, using it, as well as Luke Shaw, getting into Luke Shaw.
So you're saying the hard love, tough love works?
Some players need it, man.
Yeah. Sticking on the subject of this game, Christophe Tarreux said, Eden Hazard walked off on Saturday with a grimace and a back pain. In an average Premier League game, he gets fouled 2.6 times in the last four games against United in London, 5.5 times. Now, this guy, first of all, sounds like a massive, massive Hazard fan, which is cool because Hazard's an incredible player. But bro, getting fouled is a part of the game.
Yes.
Some people you come up with, it's more physical. If they go over the top with the fouls, you'd like to trust and believe that the referee is going to do his job and get them sent off. If they don't get sent off, then they're just playing the game. We can't act like people every single game don't make professional fouls. This sounds crazy to say, but fouling is a part of the game tactically.
100%.
So if they realize this is what we got to do to stop Hazard within reason, because what are you supposed to do? Just let him dribble you. He's so one of the best dribblers in the world.
I guarantee you half the people, more than half the people watching this that play football, when they've played on a Sunday or a Saturday, and they've played against a good player, before the game, the team talk would have been, make sure you get into him hard.
Yeah, you have
to. We
all
say that, right? You know what I mean? So there's no difference to when Mourinho comes against Chelsea, you know they're going to play on the floor, they know they've got good, skillful players, Hazard, William. Make sure you get into him.
And this is the problem with Chelsea, though, man. I feel like if Hazard doesn't show up, do they win the game? Yesterday, he didn't really show up, or the other day, and they didn't win the game.
Yeah.
They got the draw, which is obviously better than losing, but they didn't win. And you speak to a lot of Chelsea fans, and they'll tell you the same thing.
What does this 5.5 mean? Does that mean five
just
and a
average,
half?
It's just average.
Per game?
Yeah.
So you got fouled five times on average?
Yeah.
Hazard, we've spoken about him a lot on this show early on. What's your view on Hazard now?
Incredible.
How many games have you played? 10 games?
Nine games. He's incredible. Incredible. On form, definitely top five in the world. On form. I just think in games like this against Man United, you have to show up. Yeah. All right, enough of the Man United game. Let's go on to a game I know you want to talk about. And I definitely want to talk about. So, Ollie Lister on Twitter has said, Mark Noble was right about West Ham and Spurs having similar starts to the season. Both teams have only won one at the Olympic Stadium.
Oh, funny.
Wow.
Wow.
So, bro, this is the time of year where our two teams go up.
Oh, it's gutted, man.
Go head to head. This is your cup final. This is just another game for us. Another 3 points. This is your cup final. This is where extra bubbles get blown. This is where... Where extra bubbles get blown. Extra flags get put out on your seats. This is where everyone gets that real team talk in the locker room. Like, you know what this means to our fans.
Because it's a derby.
Fulham and Arsenal's a London derby.
So they should be getting up for it like that as well.
But this is the problem. Why has everyone got beef with Spurs? West Ham, Chelsea and Arsenal all equally hate Spurs.
Arsenal,
but they don't hate each other like that anymore.
Arsenal hate you because they hate you. That's your...
North London,
right,
okay.
Okay. But us, because you accused us of making you not get into Champions League, bro. Like we would ever try and poison you.
You would try and poison
us. No, I don't think we would, bro. And for us, it's like, okay, you really think that of us? We didn't have a problem with you. Now we do. It doesn't matter anyway. What are we talking about? Let's talk about Lamella. And he's been involved in, was it nine goals in 10 games?
He's been involved in 10 goals in nine games.
10 goals in nine games,
yeah, he's been an unsung hero, man. Like, he's scored important goals. He's been creating stuff in the absence of Eriksen. He's someone that not only did I not think was going to step up in this absence, I wouldn't have had him as one of the players to step up. I thought he wasn't even potentially going to be here this season.
He's been
on the fringes. No, he's always been a technically great player, but the way he's stepped up, like there's no Dele at the moment, there's no Eriksen, and Lamella is the guy that's stepping up.
What's his best position?
Who, Lamella?
Where do you want to see him play? Where did he play last game, do you know?
Not necessarily, because the three behind the striker just changed. But wide right, cuts in on his left foot.
The manager still waited and said, look, you're my guy. Once the manager says that to a player, that's
why hasn't he said that? If he's Argentinian, he's been involved in this many goals.
Maybe he might start now.
Spurs have Man City next.
Mm-hmm.
How do you see that one going? It's at Wembley.
Gonna lose.
And there's only 2 points between them, so there's a lot to play for. If Spurs beat Man City, they go above them. Yeah, West Ham. Talk to me about West Ham. How do you feel? Obviously, you lost your cup final, but how do you feel in the grand scheme of things? To be fair, you could have won if it wasn't for Hugo Lloris, or at least got a draw.
Why do we want to talk about West Ham when they lose?
Well, it's because I support Spurs.
When we were winning, no one would say nothing to me.
What are you talking about? When you beat Man United, I gave you a segment. I kept saying, this is your time. Do your thing.
But it's not a good time, is it, at West Ham? Listen, let's move on to the next post. Not a good time. But we had chances at the end. We could have nicked it, but...
So that's it. You ain't got nothing else to say. Did you even watch the game? All right, let's get on to the next one, and it comes from Bleacher Report Football, and they have said, Sergio Aguero, 149. He passes Frank Lampard and Alan Shearer for most Premier League goals for a single club. Only Wayne Rooney and Thierry Henry are ahead of him now. Shearer didn't get all his goals for Newcastle, did he? It's crazy.
Blackburn. Southampton. Oh, no. This is Premier League record, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
So it would have been Blackburn. I don't think he played Southampton, no.
How good is Sergio Aguero? Let's get straight into it because...
Unbelievable.
I'm going to come to my old debate that I always bring up. Best number nine in the world.
You're saying he's better than Suarez.
Which he is. And I used to say that even when Suarez was banging for Liverpool. And people said, I'm crazy. I don't know football.
I think you would have been crazy saying that.
Yeah, but that's why it shouldn't be about form. Then. But that's what I'm saying. It shouldn't be about that. It should just, you should be able to see who's class, what they've done. Because now, 5 years later, 4 or 5 years later, you can see that Aguero is still banging.
So what, Suarez ain't banging?
I'm not saying he is or he isn't. I'm saying Suarez isn't the form he once was.
It's a tough argument, bro. I love Aguero.
This is the problem. We've seen Suarez at his best. I don't even think we've seen Aguero at his best. He's never really completed the season, and he's got 149 goals for a single club.
You think he
will
complete this season? I hope he doesn't. I don't want to put no.
I hope he does as well. Well, part of me doesn't want him to because I don't. Then Man City will definitely win the league if he completes the season. But yeah, Aguero, have to rate him 149 goals. Man City, 10 goals in the last two games in the Premier League. Are they winning the league? Because you said Arsenal were going to win the league.
Arsenal.
Oh my God, bro. The next post comes from man like Bobby Reed. And I'm gonna read this. What a feeling that was. Covers mouth emoji. Thanks to all the fans, you made it special. And look at the way he spelled you. The man them are really doing bits, you know. You know it's man them when they spell you with just the letter U on Instagram.
Look how he spelled fans as well.
You know the agency haven't tapped him up to handle his social media. You know he's really out here, plat swinging around looking like poet.
Exactly, man.
I have to rate that, man.
Well, I can't rate it.
Why?
He's got hair like poet.
Okay.
And honestly, that hair is so childish. It's so
all
childish.
All of the footballers, especially the young ones, got childish hair right now.
He's such a player though.
Bro, he's been such a player. Best player this season. So another one of the Mandem, not exactly a youngster, but definitely Mandem, scored another goal. And the way they were celebrating, man, I just think, yes, the Mandem are out in Wales, living with sheep, it's cold, and they're doing their thing. Maybe not that part of Wales, because Cardiff's actually a very nice city, very built up.
Yes, very nice.
Fulham, are you worried? They've conceded 25 goals in 9 games. They're in the relegation zone.
And they will continue to concede as long as they continue to try and play football. How they play in football. They play from the back, which in the Championship, watching them last year, it was amazing. They were popping teams.
Premier League, different gravy.
Different gravy, mate. You got like
Bisto around here, mate.
The strikers that are chasing your defenders down, they can't only run 10 times now. They're fitter, they're stronger. So on that 10th time when you think you've got out, 11th, bang, they're getting you. You know what I mean? So like, you've got to put that
but
in.
But the thing is, they've got good players. They've got Schürrle, who scored a crazy goal, by the way.
They've got some great players.
They've got Mitro.
Yep.
They got Sessegnon. There's some players over there. They got Fosu-Mensah on loan. Mm-hmm. Seri's
been good.
That's what I'm saying. Like, really and truly, you look at their team on paper and you think to yourself, lads, this is poor. 25-9.
You're gonna, like, when, again, I repeat it, they're gonna have to start going long, which the manager won't. I've seen it. I've seen a guy, Fulham fans will tell you this, get caught on the ball and the manager say, still give it to him. Next pass, give it to him.
Either way, I hope you guys still do well in the league. Moving on, Spoof said Arsene Wenger is ready. And Arsene Wenger said, I will start again on 1st of January. I am ready to work again. So that's it. He's had his break. He's been doing head tennis, volleyball tennis, playing in matches wearing classic black leather boots.
Boating with his ex.
Boating. He's been doing it all, man. He's been enjoying his time off like someone of his age should, but he wants to stress again.
Where should he go? Where could he go? Where do you want to see him?
I want to see him in Orlando.
Bruv, funny you say that, because the USA job is still available, mate. And I think he could do the old Arsene Wenger, yeah? The guy that brought philosophies and fitness programs and health programs and all of that to the UK. If he's still got innovation in him, he would do wonders for the American game. Which I think the American game and economy could do wonders for Europe. I really do, because look how much people they've got to pick from and they could send them back over. So
football over there is at rock bottom right now as well. That would uplift them after not making the World Cup.
Would it up? That's what I'm saying. Like, is he got it though? As Arsene Wenger got it? Because he seemed like a bit of a dinosaur.
I mean, I just think as much as, you know, when I spoke to some of the Arsenal players like Bellerin, he said that Emery's giving it a fresh vibe. It needed a fresh spruce. Maybe he just needs something fresh.
Yeah.
Maybe it's not even just his tactics. are so outdated. Maybe him and Arsenal just can no longer work together.
Because he was still only...
But he can work together with someone else and it would work well.
Do you still... Maybe not the last... Well, he is because he had... It's this team, pretty much. Is he still been a few... Like, he's always been just a couple of players off having a great team still. And it was just down to his stubbornness. Maybe you're right. Maybe it's just a fresh start and... Maybe the America job could be the one.
I wouldn't want to see him do international personally because he's been linked with the likes of Real Madrid. Obviously, they potentially are going to sack their manager.
I think he's got Bayern. International pedigree in the sense that he takes, like, that's what he wants. He wants to take projects, big, big projects, man.
Yeah, but all the biggest, man, most of the biggest managers don't. They do it at club level. There's better money.
He's done it.
Yeah, but he's done it in, over here. He's done it in France and over here in Japan. Overall,
oh, who's put you done one?
No. Overall, are the leagues respected? That's all I want to know. Japan, no. France, not really.
Again, he innovated stuff in Japan, bro.
So what I'm just trying to say to you is, he's been in the Premier League for 20 plus years. Mm-hmm. There's an opportunity to now do Bundesliga, La Liga. If he can do something there, that adds to his legacy
100%,
once again.
Right?
Because his legacy's taken a bit of a hit in recent years.
I don't care, bro.
Yeah, but I know.
Do you think he need, like? Do you think he needs to do? Does he need to do more?
He doesn't need to do more, but I do believe it would be better for him to win a Champions League, because all the big managers that are in his conversation have won Champions Leagues.
Yeah.
Pep, Mourinho, Ferguson. Yeah.
Ancelotti.
All of them are going to win Champions League. Even Brian Clough won too.
You know what he needs to do then?
Like
Paris Saint-Germain, bruv.
Well, this is what I'm saying. So I feel like. Yeah, I think Wenger is someone that wants to win a Champions League, naturally, because he's someone that probably wants to be remembered in that light. And if he goes Bayern or Real Madrid, you have a good chance of winning the Champions League. They're great clubs with history of winning that competition.
Also have a good chance to mess up your legacy even more.
Can it?
Bro, good luck to Arsene Wenger, man.
Good luck to Arsene Wenger.
I just want him to succeed in whatever he does.
Do you know what? I want to see him back. Now that he's not Arsenal, I want to see him back in football. It'll be... And do you know what? If he won a Champions League, let's say he went Bayern and won the Champions League. What a middle finger that would be to Arsenal. Back to Year of the Youngster. Leave the oldies for another time. So we've got two Year of the Youngsters here, both playing in the Bundesliga. First, Mario Melchior said, 4 goals in 4 games for Reiss Nelson in the Bundesliga. English teenagers are going global with a little plane emoji. Hashtag MM love. Mario. He never forgets to hashtag it. Come like Spencer Owen. And then Football Talent Scout said, Jadon Sancho scores 11 games, 2 goals and 8 assists this season, 18 years of age. Can we talk about these two? Other than the fact that they've got the same hairstyle.
Imagine they're best friends.
No, they speak.
They
speak a lot.
They always
see them at St. George's Park.
Big each other up in their posts.
In the comments.
It's so good to see. And
do you know what I love about the young bull as well? They leave loads of like, love hearts and heart eye emojis under each other's pictures.
Because like, that's what you guys do, the youngsters now. That's the way that we're going in hip hop and everywhere. But listen, I don't mind that, you know what I mean? But it's just good to see two young kids getting a chance. Obviously, Phil Foden got on for City this week, but it's not good enough. You should be playing a lot more, especially when you're beating teams that convincingly. Like for me, you're playing Burnley, I'm putting him in. If that's me playing Football Manager, as soon as I see Burnley on the fixture, all my youngsters are getting put in. But going back to these two.
We're talking about kids, essentially, teenagers that have gone to a respected league, arguably top 3 leagues in Europe. Arguably, some might say Italy because of the revival of Juventus and Napoli and that. But arguably one of the top 3 leagues in Europe. And they do, look, 4 goals in 4 games, Reiss Nelson.
Doing well, good finish as well. His second goal was a great finish because he lifted it, keeper's near post. Bruv, that suggests to me that he's like his brain. We've always spoke about his size and is he ready like physically. His brain, some of the passes, some of the dribbles, some of the finishing.
Very clever.
From both of them, bro. Their brains are both ready to play adult football at the highest level, man.
And that's a good thing. And I agree. And you can also see what supreme confidence does to someone. Like, they're playing with
Give
confidence.
Them games, bro. Because I'm telling you, I'm looking at Reiss Nelson getting like... the odd 10 minutes here and there for Arsenal, and I'm literally thinking, bruv, this guy, ability-wise, mentally ready, but physically, I'm not sure, but it's because I'm only seeing 10 minutes, like, here and there, and it's tough to get involved, like...
If clubs can do it, which they can to an extent, put the players in, give them a chance.
Yeah, man.
Give them a few minutes at least and see what happens, man, because we've seen what they're doing over there in the Bundesliga. And I'm all for it, man. Yeah, man. I'm happy. Big up all of the youngsters. Big up Reiss Nelson. Big up Jadon Sancho.
These are two of the best, though. Yeah. If you go through, if you talk to the England young, every young player I spoke to, you spoke to, we spoke to, all said them two. So yeah, man, big up them two. And people, could you send in some names? Obviously, year of the youngster. Is there any youngsters that we maybe don't talk about? Maybe in the Championship, is there anyone from the lower leagues that are potentially good enough to play in the Prem? Yeah, send the names in, man.
Yeah, let's have a look. All right, so it is time for...
It's hard knock life for you. It's a hard knock life for you. Instead of winning, you get beat. Instead of playing fair, you just cheat. It's a hard knock life.
Deez.
Yeah.
Deez. Challenge time. All right, so he's come with the Hard Knock Life song. Big up, Stevo. With so many European leagues selling their television rights to companies that don't come with standard British TV packages, there are people watching the Championship more than ever. Today, we're going to be challenged to name the top scorers in the division over the last 10 years to see if we've been paying attention. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
You got me.
Try and cut your tongue.
You ask me first,
Greg. All right, you ready?
Yes.
Music. Check out this bazaar. All right. Which player has scored 120 championship goals for Cardiff, Fulham, Aston Villa, and Nottingham Forest? 3, 2, 1. Ross McCormack.
Which player has scored 101 championship goals for Ipswich, Blackburn, Middlesbrough, Sheffield Wednesday and Norwich?
Andy Cole?
Jordan Rhodes.
All right, which player has scored 98 championship goals for Sheffield United, Doncaster, Southampton, Reading and Leeds?
Three. Billy Sharp.
Who?
Billy Sharp.
That was sharp thinking.
Which player has scored 87 championship goals for Preston, Portsmouth, Leicester, Middlesbrough, and Derby County? 10, 9.
Is it Nugent? Which player scored 78 championship goals for Cardiff? Peter Whittingham.
Yeah, should have got that. Should get this one, it's easy. So easy. Which player has scored 77 championship goals for Watford?
Tridini. Oh, it's 2-1. No! If I beat you on a championship thing. Which player, Stevo, has scored 67 championship goals for Crystal Palace, Reading and Brighton? Oh, it's so easy.
Yes.
Are you kidding me, bro? 10.
Glenn Murray. 9. It is 2-2. If you get this, you win on your return back in the hot seat.
Go on then.
Okay, are you ready?
Go on.
Which player has scored 44 championship goals for Watford, Norwich, West Ham, Forest and Aston Villa?
Is this for the win? Dunno. Who is it?
It's my mucker. H to the L.
Harry Lansbury.
Henry.
Stop it.
Lansbury. My G. He's got 44 championship goals. Nearly at 50. Go on, H.
Unlucky. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Craig.
Yes.
Dwight Gale has scored 44 championship goals for three teams. Can you name two of them?
Newcastle and Crystal Palace.
Is one of them.
Is there only one?
He was with Crystal Palace in the Premier League. West Brom.
Okay.
Yeah?
4, 3, 2, 1.
Peterborough.
It was slightly after the one, but okay, cool. Just because you got it.
Wow. Tab them. After that win, my heart is beating. It was a good little, that was a good tiebreaker.
Bro, I didn't even think we'd get to a tiebreaker. I'm kind of happy.
Well, I didn't think we was going to get to a tiebreaker when you was leading, but I'm kind of happy. Showed that Manchester United spirit. But tab them, we've got a question for you, as always. And the question is, name the current Championship player to have scored 71 goals in the division for Stoke, Blackpool, Nottingham Forest, and Derby County. Leave your answers in the comments.
That's it. End of the show. Guys, thank you so much for watching.
Yeah.
As per usual, tab them, tabby cats. We love you. And if you're one of the pagans that still hasn't subscribed to the channel, watch this every week. unpagan yourself and hit the subscribe button. If you're a pagan that doesn't like the video but enjoys the content, unpagan yourself and drop the video a like. And also just hit the bell so you know when the videos are coming out, so you don't have to search for it.
Yeah.
Just do that. Just come straight on your phone, unless you've got a Nokia.
And I love you.
And he loves you. Should we try and get the handshake now? Yes, possibly. Are you going to get the right fingers?
Yep.
Are you going to just disrespect the team? Watch.
Oh, wow, I've got it terrible.
Wrong. Two peace signs down.